Welcome friends, this is Shubham Bhoyar from NIT Warangal. Welcome to Mathematics class. So we were discussing about trigonometric functions. So moving on, we discussed some trigonometric identities earlier. So we will be discussing some more further. So now we will see sine 3x expansion, that is equal to 3 sine x minus 4 sine cube x. So we can write sine 3x as sine 2x plus x, that is 2x plus x is equal to 3. So we can write sine 3x equals to sine 2x plus x, which is equal to sine 2x cos x plus cos 2x sine x. As we can recollect the earlier identities of sine 2x, it was sine x cos x plus cos x sine x. So we can apply the same identity here and expand sine 2x plus x into sine 2x into cos x plus cos 2x into sine x. So here as you can see, this sine x can further be expanded into 2 sine x and into cos x. There is here this 2 sine x cos x. It is the expansion of sine 2x into, as usual, a cos x term. Plus this cos 2x can be further expanded into 1 minus 2 sin square x into sin x. Further, these two cos x can be multiplied and we will get cos square x, that is this term will be 2 sin x into cos square x. As we know, cos square x can also be written as 1 minus sin square x, since sin square x plus cos square x is equal to 1. So this cos square x term can be written as 1 minus 2 sin square x. And we are now expanding this bracket into, that is sin x into 1 will be sin x, and minus 2 sin square x into sin x will give us minus 2 sin cube x. If we expand this bracket further in this step, we will get 2 sin x into 1, that is 2 sin x, minus 2 sin x into minus sin square x, that is minus 2 sin cube x, plus this term as usual we are writing here, that is sin x minus 2 sin cube x. Finally, we will add this sin x and sin x term, we will get 3 sin x, and we will add this sin cube x term, we will get minus 4 sin cube x. Once again, we will see how we derive sin 3x function. So sin 3x can be also be written as sin 2x plus x. So applying the identity, sin of a plus b equals to sin a cos b plus cos a sin b. So this will give us sin x, sin 2x into cos x plus cos 2x into sin x. Sin 2x can be further written as 2 sin x cos x, that is 2 sin x cos x into cos x as usual. And cos 2x can be written as 1 minus 2 sin square x into sin x written as usual. Now we have 2 cos x, so it will result into cos square x, which can also be written as 1 minus sin square x, since sin square x plus cos square x equals to 1. So 2 sin x into cos square x, that is 1 minus sin square x, plus we are expanding this bracket here, that is sin x into 1, here will be sin x, and minus 2 sin square x into sin x will give minus 2 sin cube x. Also we will expand this bracket in the next step, that is 2 sin x into 1 will give 2 sin x, and 2 sin x into minus sin square x will give minus 2 sin cube x, and sin x minus 2 sin cube x will be written as it is. Adding sin x term and sin cube x term, we will get 3 sin x minus 4 cos cube x. Sorry, 3 sin x minus 4 sin cube x. Now we'll see how we can write cos 3x into some simplified term. So as we did earlier in sin 3x, we'll write cos 3x is equal to cos 2x plus x, since 3x can be expressed as 2x plus x. So after expanding this, as we know the identity, cos of x plus y is equal to cos x cos y minus sin x sin y. So applying the same identity here, we will get, we will assume 2x as x and x as y. So cos 2x into cos x minus sin 2x minus sin x will be expansion for cos 2x plus x. Cos 2x can be written as 2 cos cube, 2 cos square x minus 1 into cos x written as usual. And sin 2x can be written as 2 sin x into cos x, and sin x written as it is. Now we will expand this bracket here, That is, here we have one sin x term, and here we have another sin x term. Here this is another sin x term. So we will get sin square x. As we know, sin square x can also be written as 1 minus cos square x, since sin square x plus cos square x equals to 1. So these two sin x term when multiplied we get sin square x, and it can be written as 1 minus cos square x. And cos x is remaining, so we'll write it as it is. So next step can be 2 cos square x minus 1 into cos x minus 2 cos x into 1 minus cos square x. Now we'll expand the bracket in both the terms. That is, 2 cos square x into cos x will be equal to 2 cos cube x minus 1 into cos x will be equal to minus cos x, minus 2 cos x into 1 will be equal to minus 2 cos x, and minus 2 cos x into minus cos square x will be equal to plus 2 cos cube x. So adding cos term and cos cube x term, we get 2 cos cube x plus 2 cos cube x equal to 4 cos cube x, and minus cos x into minus 2 cos x, we get minus 3 cos x. Again, we will see how we derived this cos 3x equal to 4 cos cube x minus 3 cos x. As we know, cos 3x can be written as cos 2x plus x, where we can expand this into cos 2x into cos x minus sin 2x into sin x. Further, cos 2x can be written as 2 cos square x minus 1, and sin 2x can be written as 2 sin x into cos x. So we are expanding this cos 2x and sin 2x term, so we will get 2 cos square x minus 1 into cos x minus of 2 sin x into cos x into sin x. So here we have 2 sin x term in multiplication that will result into sin square x, which can be written as 1 minus cos square x. So we are writing here as 1 sin square x as 1 minus cos square x, and cos x as it is. Now we'll expand the bracket in both the terms. That is, 2 cos square x minus 1 into cos x will be written as 2 cos cube x minus cos x, since 2 cos square x into cos x equals to 2 cos cube x, and minus 1 into cos x can be written as minus cos x. And the other term, 2 cos x into 1 minus cos square x, can be written as 2 cos x plus 2 cos cube x, since minus of 2 cos x into 1 gives minus 2 cos x, and minus 2 cos x into minus cos square x gives positive 2 cos cube x. Now adding cos cube x term and cos x term, we get 4 cos cube x minus 3 cos x. Now we can do the same for tan 3x, which will be getting as 3 tan x minus 10 cube x minus 1 minus 3 tan square x. Here we need to specify the angle 3x as it should not be equal to n pi plus pi by 2, because as we can recollect, if tan theta can always be defined as when theta is not equal to n pi plus pi by 2 or odd multiple of pi by 2, since cos theta will be 0 for that term. So tan 3x will be equal to tan 2x plus x. As we know, 3x can be expressed as 2x plus x. Applying the identity, tan of x plus y will be equal to tan x plus tan y upon 1 minus tan x tan y. So we'll assume 2x as x and x as y. So applying the identity, tan 2x plus x will be equal to tan 2x plus tan x upon 1 minus tan 2x into tan x, written here in denominator. Now tan 2x can be further simplified into 2 tan x upon 1 minus tan square x plus x, written as it is. Here also tan 2x will be simplified as 2 tan x upon 1 minus tan square x into tan x, that is written in numerator. When we multiply this whole term with 1 minus tan square x, we will get 2 tan x, that is, we already have 1 minus tan square x in the denominator of this term. So when we multiply 1 minus tan square x, this denominator term and numerator term will get cancelled, and we will get 2 tan x plus tan x into 1 minus tan square x will give tan x minus 10 cube x. Going to denominator, when we multiply 1 with 1 minus tan square x, we will get 1 minus tan square x, and when we multiply tan square x to this 1 minus tan square x to this term, the denominator tan square x and numerator tan square x will get cancelled, and we will get 2 tan square x. Like this, 2 tan x into tan x will be remaining, so 2 tan square x. Then simplifying the term, we will get 3 tan x minus 10 cube x upon 1 minus 3 tan square x. we will again see how we got this term, how we got this identity. Tan 3x can be written as tan 2x plus x, which can be expanded by the identity. Tan of x plus y is equal to tan x plus tan y upon 1 minus tan x into tan y. So tan 2x plus x can be written as tan 2x plus tan x upon 1 minus tan 2x into tan x. Tan 2x is again expanded into 2 tan x upon 1 minus tan square x. Same is in denominator. It is expanded as 2 tan x upon 1 minus tan square x, and this tan square x is multiplied in numerator. And now we are multiplying the whole term, this whole term, with 1 minus tan square x. So when we multiply this term, 2 tan x upon 1 minus tan square x into tan square x, we obtain 2 tan x. When we multiply this term, tan x into 1 minus tan square x, we get tan x minus tan cube x. When we multiply this term, 1 into 10, 1 minus tan square x, we get 1 minus tan square x. When we multiply this term, that is 2 tan x into tan x upon 1 minus tan square x into 1 minus tan square x, we get 2 tan square x. And negative sign was earlier here, so it will be written as negative. In all, we write this tan x term, and we will add this tan square x term. So we will get 3 tan x minus tan cube x upon 1 minus 3 tan square x, where the important condition is 3x should not belong to n pi plus minus, where the important condition is 3x should not belong to n pi plus pi by 2, because it is an odd multiple of pi by 2, where cos 3x will be equal to 0. So tan 3x won't be defined. Now we will find some identities, like cos x plus cos y equal to 2 cos of x plus y by 2 into cos of x minus y by 2. Second is cos x minus cos y equal to minus of 2 cos x minus cos y equal to minus 2 sin x plus y by 2 sin of x minus y by 2. Third is sin x plus sin y equal to 2 sin of x plus y by 2 cos of x minus y by 2. Fourth is sin x minus sin y equal to 2 cos of x plus y by 2 sin of x minus y by 2. So we have some earlier known identities as cos of x plus y equal to cos x cos y minus sin x sin y, and also we have cos of x minus y equal to cos x cos y plus sin x sin y. So if we add and subtract both these equations or identities, we can obtain, when we add, we will obtain cos of x plus y plus cos of x minus y on LHS, and when we add these two equations, this sin x sin y term will get cancelled because it has opposite sign and we are adding. So on the right hand side, we will obtain 2 cos x cos y. When we subtract these two terms, we subtract this lower equation with above equation, we will obtain cos of x plus y minus cos of x minus y, and on the LHS. And on RHS, we will obtain minus of 2 sin x sin y, because when we are subtracting, this sign will change here, and sin of cos x cos y will get negative, and sin of sin x sin y also will be getting negative. So now if we subtract these two equations, so cos x cos y will get cancelled, and sin x sin y will be added. So cos of x plus y minus cos of x minus y will give minus of 2 sin x sin y. Proceeding, sin of x plus y is equal to sin x cos y plus cos x sin y. This is also an earlier known identity which we proved in previous slides. Also, sin of x minus y is equal to sin x cos y minus cos x sin y. If we add and subtract both these equations, we will obtain sin of x plus y plus sin of x minus y on LHS on addition. And on addition, this cos x sin y term will get cancelled. So on RHS, we will obtain 2 sin x cos y. So sin of x plus y plus sin of x minus y will give 2 sin x cos y. If we subtract these two equations, then we will get sin of x plus y minus sin of x minus y on LHS, while sin x cos y term will get cancelled because sin will be different in subtraction, and cos x sin y term will get added. So on RHS we will obtain 2 cos x sin y as the result. So on adding we will obtain sin of x plus y plus sin of x minus y equal to 2 sin x cos y, and on subtracting we will obtain sin of x minus y minus sin of x plus y, sorry, sin of x plus y minus sin of x minus y will give 2 cos x sin y. Now we'll consider x plus y equal to theta and x minus y equal to phi. So we obtained here this equation. Earlier also we obtained 2 equations after subtracting and adding, that is cos of x plus y plus cos of x minus y equals to 2 cos x cos y, and cos of x plus y minus cos of x minus y equal to minus 2 sin x sin y. So if we consider x plus y equal to theta and x minus y equal to phi, so this will transform into cos theta plus cos phi equal to, we will also add these two equations, like we assume x plus y equal to theta and x minus y equal to phi, so we will add these two, so we will get x equal to theta plus phi by 2, because when we add these two equations we will get 2x equal to theta plus phi, which can be written as x equal to theta plus phi by 2. When we subtract these two equations we will get 2y equal to theta minus phi by 2, sorry, 2y equal to theta minus phi, so it can be written as y equal to theta by phi, theta minus phi by 2. So we are now assuming x plus y equal to theta, x minus y equal to phi, and x equal to theta plus phi by 2, and y equal to theta minus phi by 2. So here we obtained two equations, cos of x plus y plus cos of x minus y equal to 2 cos x cos y, and cos of x plus y minus cos of x minus y equal to minus 2 sin x sin y. So as we assume x plus y equal to theta, x minus y equal to phi, and x equal to theta plus phi by 2, and y equal to theta minus phi by 2. So this equation can be rewritten as cos theta plus cos phi equal to 2 cos of theta plus phi by 2 and into 2 cos of theta minus phi by 2. So the equation we'll be getting will be cos theta plus cos phi equal to 2 cos theta plus phi by 2 into cos theta minus phi by 2, and this lower equation will be cos theta minus cos phi will be equal to minus of 2 sin theta plus phi by 2 into sin theta minus phi by 2. We again obtained these two equations by adding and subtracting two identities. So these can be written as sin of theta since x plus y equal to theta plus sin of phi since x minus y equal to phi equal to 2 sin of theta plus phi by 2 since x is assumed as theta plus phi by 2, and cos of theta minus phi by 2 since y is assumed as theta minus phi by 2. The lower equation will be written as sin theta minus sin phi equal to 2 cos of theta plus phi by 2 into sin of theta minus phi by 2. As you can see here, we just replaced our assumptions, that is x plus y equal to theta and x minus y equal to phi, into these obtained equations, and we are getting this result, which are our identities, what we are trying to prove here. These were the identities we are trying to prove, and we are obtained these identities here. Moving on. Now we'll solve some problems related to trigonometric functions. Convert 40 degree 20 minutes into radian measure. As we can recollect, we have known that 180 degree equals to pi radian, as we have proved with the considering the area of circle. So since 180 degree equal to pi radian, so 40 degree 20 minutes can be written as 40 into 1 by 3 as mixed fraction, since we know 1 degree equal to 60 minute, so 20 degree will be equal to 20 by 60, that is 1 by 3 degree, which will be equal to pi by 80 into 121 by 3. 121 by 3 is nothing but this fraction, that is 40 into 3, that is 120 plus 1, so 121 by 3, and we will obtain that radian measure of 40 degree 20 minutes. Find the radius of the circle in which a central angle of 60 degree intercepts an arc of length 37.4 cm. So here we'll assume the length of arc as L equal to 37.4 cm and theta, that is the angle subtended by the arc, is 60 degree. So when we convert this 60 degree to radian, we will get as 60 pi by 180, that is pi by 3. So as we know, the area of circle was derived from r equal to L by theta, where L is the length of the arc and theta is the angle subtended by the arc, and r is the radius of the circle. From this equation we derive the area of circle, that is pi r square or 2 pi r, we derive the circumference of the circle. This is the basic equation for derivation, that is r theta equal to L or r equal to L by theta. So substituting the values, we get as r equal to 37.4 into 3, that is pi by 3 or pi by 3 radian. Here we have to assume the value of pi equal to 22 by 7. We can also assume it as 3.14. so here we are taking it as 22 by 7. So r equal to L by theta, where value of L is 37.4, value of theta is pi by 3, that is 22 by 7 into 3, which will be equal to 35.7. Moving on to next question, if cot x equal to 5 by 12, x lies in second quadrant, find the values of other 5 trigonometric functions. So since we know cot x equal to minus 5 by 12, because in second quadrant, sine is positive while cos is negative, so cot x equal to cos x upon sine x. So since cos is negative, sine is positive, so cot will be negative. So cot x will be equal to minus 5 by 12. So tan x will be equal to its reciprocal, that is minus of 12 by 5. We know the identity, 6 square x equal to 1 plus tan square x. So 1 plus tan square x, that is 12 square upon 5 square, or 144 by 125 will be equal to 169 by 25. So this is 6 square x. When we take the root of this, we will get two values, plus minus 13 by 5 for sec x. Now since x lies in second quadrant, sec x will be negative since cos is negative, so sec x will be equal to minus 13 by 5 and positive value will be discarded. So cos will be its reciprocal, that is minus of 5 by 13. Sin x will be obtained as tan x into cos x, because tan x equal to sin x upon cos x. So product of tan x into cos x will give us sin x. So minus of 12 by 5, that is tan value, and minus 5 by 13, that is cos value, will give us sine value, that is 12 by 13. Cos x value can be obtained as 1 upon sin x, that is 13 by 12. In this way, we will be proceeding in such type of question. We need to take care about the angle in which quadrant it is lying, because according to quadrant, the sign of trigonometric function changes or the value changes. Find the value of sin 31 pi by 3. So as we know, sin value keeps on repeating after every 2 pi or every 2 pi interval of every 2 pi. So sin value repeats itself after an interval of 2 pi. So sin 31 pi can be written as sin 10 pi plus pi by 3. 10 pi, as we know, is an integral multiple of 2 pi. So it won't matter, we can neglect this 10 pi, because as we know, sine value does not change, even sine value does not change after integral multiple of 2 pi. So 10 pi is the integral multiple. So if we rotate the angle by an integral multiple of 2 pi, the sine value won't be changing. So sine of 10 pi plus pi by 3 can be written as sine pi by 3, which is equal to root 3 by 2. Find the value of sine 15 degree. So as we know, sin 15 degree can be written as sin of 45 degree minus 30 degree, since 45 minus 30 is equal to 15. So we can apply the identity here, sin of x minus y, which is sin x cos y plus cos x sin y. Sorry, sin of x minus y is equal to sin x cos y minus cos x sin y. So x can be assumed as 45 and y can be assumed as 30. So expanding, sin of 45 minus 30 will be equal to sin 45 cos 30 minus cos 45 sin 30. Now when we put the values of sine 45, cos 30, cos 45, sine 30, we will get the value as root 3 minus 1 upon 2 root 2. Now we will prove that 3 sine pi by 6 into sec pi by 3 minus 4 sine of 5 pi by 6 into cot of pi by 4 equal to 1. In such question, we approach as we take H LHS, simplify it and obtain the value of RHS. So LHS is equal to 3 sine pi by 6 into sec pi by 3 minus 4 sine 5 pi by 6 into cot pi by 4. So as we know the value of sine pi by 6, sec pi by 3 and sine pi by 6, 5 pi by 6 can be expressed as sine of pi minus pi by 6 and we know the value of cot pi by 4. So we will substitute the values known and sine of 5 pi by 6 can be expressed as sine of pi minus pi by 6. So whenever we have such term sine of pi minus something or considered as x, so sine of pi minus x is equal to minus sine x as we know. So this term will get positive, that is minus of 3 into half into 2 minus 4 sine pi minus pi by 6 will be equal to minus of 4 sine pi by 6. Since we know that value of sine does not change after pi interval, so we will the sine of this won't be changing. Since sine pi minus since sine of pi minus x is equal to sine x as we know her, so this term sine of pi minus pi by 6 will be equal to sine pi by 6, and after doing the calculation we will obtain this as 1, that is we will obtain the RHS. Now we will prove that sine of x plus y upon sine of x minus y is equal to 10x plus 10y upon 10x minus 10y. So we have LHS as sine of x plus y upon sine of x minus y. Expanding this we get, according to the identity, we get sine of x into cos y plus cos x sin y upon sin x cos y minus cos x sin y. These are the expansions of sin x plus y and sin of x minus y respectively. Dividing the numerator and denominator by cos x cos y, we obtained as when we divide the numerator and denominator by cos x cos y. So considering this term sin x cos y, when we divide this with cos x cos y, we will obtain sin x upon cos x, that is 10x. When we divide this term cos x sin y by cos x cos y, so cos x term will get cancelled and we will obtain sin x upon cos y, that is 10y. When we divide this term sin x cos y upon cos x cos y, so cos x term cos y will term will get cancelled and we will obtain sin x upon cos x, that is 10x. And when we divide this term cos x sin y upon cos x cos y, so cos x term will get cancelled and we will obtain sin y upon cos y, so 10y. Thus we have proved and got RHS. Show that tan 3x into tan 2x into tan x equal to tan 3x minus tan 2x minus tan x. So we know that 3x equal to 2x plus x, that is when we take the value of tan 3x we will get tan 2x plus x as we have done earlier, and we have also obtained this value of tan 3x during derivation, that is tan 3x is equal to tan 2x plus x upon 1 minus tan 2x into tan x. So when we take this denominator term to LHS and multiply it with tan 3x, we obtained the value as tan 3x into 1, that is tan 3x minus, we'll multiply tan 3x with tan 2x into tan x, that is we'll obtain tan 3x into tan 2x into tan x is equal to this numerator side. When we take this all this term the right hand side terms to left hand side and take this tan 3x, tan 2x and tan x term to right hand side, we'll obtain it as tan 3x minus tan 2x minus tan x is equal to tan 3x into tan x into tan 2x. So thus we have proved the what we need to, that is tan 3x into tan 2x into tan x is equal to tan 3x minus tan 2x into minus tan x. Now next question is prove that cos of pi by 4 plus x plus cos of pi by 4 minus x equal to root 2 cos x. This is simple question, and we'll be expanding this cos pi by 4 plus x term and cos pi by 4 minus x term. So we have LHS as cos pi by 4 plus x plus cos pi by 4 minus x. So in this case, as you can recollect, we have, in the ending we have derived some identities where cos a plus cos b was equal to cos of a plus b by 2 into cos of a minus b by 2 into 2. So same we will do here. We will assume this pi by 4 plus term as a and this pi by 4 minus x term as b. So the identity was cos a plus cos b is equal to 2 cos of a plus b by 2 into cos of a minus b by 2. So expanding this, 2 cos of a was pi by 4 plus x and b was pi by 4 minus x. So 2 cos of a plus b, that is pi by 4 plus x plus pi by 4 minus x by 2 into cos of a minus b by 2, that is pi by 4 plus x minus of minus of pi by 4 minus x by 2. So after simplification we will get 2 cos pi by 4 into cos x, which will be equal to 2 into 1 by root 2 cos x, that is root 2 cos x. So we have obtained RHS. Next question is prove that cos square x plus cos square x plus pi by 3 plus cos square x minus pi by 3 equal to 3 by 2. So here we have LHS as cos square x plus cos square x plus pi by 3 plus cos square x minus pi by 3. So as we know, cos square x can be written as 1 plus cos 2x by 2. That is, as you can recollect, cos 2x can be written as cos square x minus 1. So as you can recollect, cos 2x can be written as 2 cos square x minus 1. So when we rewrite these terms as in terms of cos square x, so we will get as 1 plus cos 2x by 2 plus, here also applying the same identity, that is cos square something can be written as 2 cos square something minus 1. So it will be written as 1 plus cos of 2x into 2 pi by 3 upon 2. That is the same identity as we applied in this term is applied in this term as well as in this term. So cos square x can be written as 1 plus cos 2x by 2, same as cos square x plus pi by 3 can be written as 1 plus cos 2x plus 2 pi by 3 by 2 plus cos square x minus pi by 3 can be written as 1 plus cos 2x minus 2 pi by 3 by 2. Taking half as common outside the bracket, we get as half we have taken common outside, so half of 1 plus 1 plus 1, that is 3, cos 2x, cos of 2x plus 2 pi by 3 and cos of 2x minus 2 pi by 3. So when we expand this, here we have an equation like cos of 2x plus 2 pi by 3 plus cos of 2x minus 2 pi by 3. So here we can apply the identity as cos of a plus cos b is equal to 2 cos a plus b by 2 and into cos of a minus b by 2. That is, we are considering a equal to 2x and b equal to minus 2 pi by 3. Sorry, b equal to 2 pi by 3. So when we apply the identity, after applying the identity, we get it as half of 3 plus cos 2x into 2 cos 2x into cos of 2 pi by 3. Since it can be considered as a plus b, it can be considered as a minus b. So where a is equal to 2x and b equal to 2 pi by 3. We can simplify this term, cos 2x plus 2 pi by 3 plus cos 2x minus 2 pi by 3, in two ways. Either we consider a equal to 2x and b equal to 2 pi by 3 and get this, or we can do as 2x plus 2 pi by 3 can be considered as a and 2x minus 2 pi by 3 can be considered as b, and we can solve this. So we know we will do it as a equal to 2x plus 2 pi by 3 and b equal to 2x minus 2 pi by 3. So cos a plus cos b is equal to 2 cos of a plus b by 2 into cos of a minus b by 2. So when we do a plus b, we will add 2x plus 2y with 2x minus 2y, 2 pi by 3. So 2 pi by 3 terms will get cancelled and we will get 4x, that is a plus b is equal to 4x upon 2, will get 2x. So a plus b by 2 term is this one, that is 2x, and a minus b, that is 2x plus 2 pi by 3 minus of 2x minus 2 pi by 3 will give us 4 pi by 3 upon 2, that is 2 pi by 3. So a minus b term is this one. So we will get as half of 3 plus cos 2x plus 2 cos 2x into cos 2 pi by 3. So we can again simplify 2 pi by 3 as pi minus pi by 3. And as we know, cos of pi minus x is equal to minus of cos x. So it can be written as cos of pi minus pi by 3 can be written as minus of cos pi by 3. So this plus term will get minus. So it half of 3 plus cos 2x plus 2 cos 2x into cos of pi minus pi by 3 can be written as half of 3 plus cos 2x minus 2 cos 2x into cos pi by 3. So we know the value of cos pi by 3 and we'll substitute it, and we'll get as half of 3 plus cos 2x into minus half of 3 plus cos 2x minus cos 2x is equal to 3 by 2. Since cos 2x terms will get cancelled, we will get 3 by 2 as RHS. Next problem is, if tan x equal to 3 by 4, pi lying x lying between pi and 3 pi by 2, the value of sin x by 2, cos x by 2 and tan x by 2 is needed. So since x lies between pi and 3 pi by 2, that is it lies in third quadrant, so sin x will be negative, cos x will be negative. If we divide the whole inequality by 2, that is pi by 2 is greater than or equal is greater than x pi by 2, sorry, pi by 2 is smaller than x pi 2 is smaller than 3 pi by 4. So sin of x by 2 is positive and cos of x by 2 is negative. Since it is lying in third quadrant, it is lying in fourth quadrant, second quadrant, so sin will be positive and cos will be negative. Sin of x by 2 will be positive and cos of x by 2 will be negative. So as we know, sec square x equal to 1 plus tan square x, which is equal to 1 plus 9 by 16. Since tan x value is 3 by 4, so tan square x will be 9 by 16. So sec square x value will be 1 plus 9 by 16, that is 25 by 16. So cos square x is a reciprocal of 1 upon sin sec square x, so it will be 16 by 25, or cos x will be minus of 4 by 5. Since x lies between pi and 3 pi by 2, that is third quadrant, so cos x will be negative, so cos x value will be minus of 4 by 5. Now 2 sin square x by 2 is equal to 1 minus cos x. Here, as we recollect the identity, cos 2x is equal to 2 sin square x minus 1, 1 minus 2 sin square x. Cos 2x was equal to 1 minus 2 sin square x. So applying the same identity here, 2x is assumed to be x, so x will be x by 2. So 2 sin square x by 2 equal to 1 minus cos x. So cos x value is minus 4 by 5, minus minus will become plus. So 2 sin square x by 2 is equal to 1 minus cos x, which will be equal to 1 plus 4 by 5, that is 9 by 5. So sin square x will be equal, sin square x by 2 will be equal to 9 by 10, since it was twice the value, so it will be equal to 9 by 10. So sin x by 2 value will be equal to 3 by root 10. And since x by 2 lies in second quadrant, where sin value is positive, so it will be positive value of the square root will be considered, that is 3 by root 10. Same way, 2 cos square x by 2 is equal to 1 plus cos x, since cos 2x was equal to 2 cos square x minus 1. Applying that identity here, we get it as 2 cos square x by 2 plus 1 plus cos x is equal to 1 minus 4 by 5, that is 4 by 5 is the cos x value, which is equal to 1 by 5. So cos square x by 2 equal to 1 by 10, since 2 cos square x by 2 is equal to 1 by 5. So taking 2 here, it will be multiplied in the denominator. So cos square x by 2 is equal to 1 by 10, which gives cos x by 2 is equal to minus of 1 by root 10. Minus because x by 2 lies in second quadrant where cos values are negative. So minus value will be considered and positive will be discarded. Hence, tan x by 2 equal to sin x by 2 by cos x by 2, which is equal to minus 3. Since 3 by root 10 upon minus of 1 by root 10 will be equal to minus 3. So summing up, we discussed in this module about trigonometric identities, and we solved some problems, also derived some more identities. For better understanding of these topics, find the study material at www.webcoach. Also, you can follow textbooks, that is NCERT textbook and Tata McGraw-Hill. So, thank you for joining in this session.